The shiur today being presented on the basic introduction to Rosh Hashanah is dedicated for the complete recovery of Raphael Eliezer Ben Lea, a good friend in the community. He should be of a full recovery. Let's start off by informing you on Rosh Hashanah. I notice many times people will open up a siddur on Rosh Hashanah, the regular prayer book, and expect to find Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur in there. But Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur have their own special book. It's called the Machzor. And everybody should be sure that they go out and get themselves a Machzor before the holidays, so when they go to shul, or make sure the shul, the synagogue they're going to, has a prayer book called the Machzor in it, because the prayers for the Rosh Hashanah holiday are unique, much longer than the normal prayers, and different, and will not be found in the standard prayer book. Second important piece of information, that when you start, don't wait until Rosh Hashanah to be the first time that you're going to see your Machzor and the prayers that are in it. Be sure that you take a look at your Machzor before you go to shul, before you go to the synagogue. Study the words, study the pattern, study the order of the Machzor. There's a great deal to be learned about what you're about to do in shul and what the meaning of the day is. And so oftentimes people will finally come into shul after years of doing this year in, year out, and they're sorry, they kick themselves when they get to the synagogue and they start praying. They didn't take a little bit of time before to review things that they want to concentrate on and say when they were doing their praying. We can find the essence of what Rosh Hashanah is really in the Machzor, the prayer book for Rosh Hashanah, in the section called Musaf, which is the additional service that is done in the morning, the late part of the morning. And in that section, there are three specific individual prayers that come into the prayer service. One of them is called Malchus, kingship. Second is called Zichronot, it's called remembrances. And the third section is called Shofar. And those three words, Malchus, Zichronot, and Shofar, highlight for us, really, the essence of the day of Rosh Hashanah. Number one, Rosh Hashanah is a day to sit and reflect and declare that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the creator of the universe, God Almighty, has a position with us and in terms of the universe of being the king of the universe, the sole and ultimate king. You know, there can only be one king to a kingdom if it's going to work. There's only one God in the world, and Rosh Hashanah is the day to coronate that king and make Hashem king over us, which puts us in the position of being servants and slaves to that king. The recognition of this position of ourselves to HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the essence of the day of Rosh Hashanah, the coronation of the king. Number two, Zichronot, remembrances. This is a day that we should sit and spend to remember the day, the 2 days, because Rosh Hashanah is a 2-day holiday worldwide, to remember that we're constantly being filmed, we're constantly being watched by the King of Kings. The Malchus is watching us and helping to direct our lives, to improve ourselves, to grow spiritually. And it's a day of remembering there's nothing you do in this world that isn't remembered, nothing goes unnoticed. And there's no such thing as hiding in the closet because you don't want anybody to see. There's no such thing as running away from Malchus. The king is wherever you are, always watching. And this is the second part of the prayer book that informs us of the essence of the day. And thirdly is Shofar. Shofar, they call, this is called Yom HaTruah, the day of the blowing of the Shofar. This is the day of the sounding of the voice of the Shofar, and we'll talk about that in a little bit more detail in just a minute. But first I want to take care of one contradiction that people have on this day. What's that contradiction? If you were going to a court of human beings, where you were going to be judged by a judge and human beings, you'd be petrified, you'd be terrified. It would be a day of worry, what's going to happen, what's going to be the verdict. And here we are celebrating with feasts and meals and everything else on Rosh Hashanah, besides davening that has a great joy to it. How could it be? We have to understand that the joy of Rosh Hashanah is the coronation of a king who is absolutely just. Rosh Hashanah being the beginning of the year, the first day of the new year, there's a judgment on every single human being in the world. Every single Jewish person, every single non-Jewish person, the animals are judged. The judgments come on this day of Rosh Hashanah. And on this day, our joy and our celebration in that we have a just king. Because without true justice in the world, we might as well check out of here now. This world, as we've seen, has denigrated itself down to a very low level of humanity in most places. But there's a just and righteous king that's watching over us. Our celebration is that justice in the end will prevail. And it's true that we're being judged and we have that fearfulness of a judgment that won't be to the best that we might wish. It will certainly be true. But this day will be a day we celebrate that the God is a just king. And now back to the shofar. The shofar that we blow on Rosh Hashanah has three distinct sounds. The first sound you always hear before the series of the shofar blasts is a tekiah, a long straight blow, which symbolizes stability, and the place that we're coming from is strong and established. Then we have three combination sounds in the middle, which is the essence of the shofar. It's called Yom Teruah. One is a teruah, which is a weeping sound, like somebody who breaks down and cries completely or laughs completely for the joyous side. Then we have what we call a shvorim, which is a moping, a sobbing sound, like a groaning. And then we have a shvorim truah, which is a combination of the two. There's an argument among the rabbis of how a person cries or what the crying's for, and therefore we incorporate, and you always hear those three different kinds of truahs or shvorim truahs when you're talking about the sound of the shofar. And every series of shofar blasts ends up with another long blow, a tekiah. And this is the essence of life. You're going right along, something happens that knocks you off center, you get to the shvorim truah, and then you come back, you grow from that, Hashem dissettles you, so to speak, or off-centers you, you come back and you recover, and you come back to what again? To another tekiah, the full blow. So you always start off from the strength. The story of life is we break down on these days of judgment, we're judged and we're broken down, and Hashem's purpose and the purpose of life is to build ourselves back up to start, to come back with another tekiah at the end of strength.